Hello guys, this lecture is about DCL, Data Control Language, which is a part of SQL, Structured Query Language. In SQL, we have DDL, Data Definition Language, we have DQL, Data Query Language, DML, Data Manipulation Language, and DCL, Data Control Language. Today, we will study about DCL, Data Control Language. During this lecture, we will also practice some commands about DCL. Actually, DCL is about the assignment of privileges in an environment where we have multiple users of a database. Simply, we can say that using DCL, we can grant and revoke privileges to different users. So in DCL we have actually two things. First one is grant, the second thing is revoke. With the help of these two commands, we assign privileges to users and we may cancel these assignments with the help of revoke. So about DCL, we have a definition. DCL commands are used to enforce data security in a multi-user database environment. We have two commands, grant and revoke. Actually, in the database, the database administrators of the database object can provide or remove privileges on a database object. Database objects can be database itself, it can be views, it can be tables, and even a single attribute in the table. With the help of grant command, we can provide access or privileges to a single user or multiple users, so they may use objects. The syntax for this command is grant, this is a keyword, then the privilege name, it can be select, it can be update, delete, execute, anything. Then we have another keyword, on, and the name of object. It can be the entire database, it can be a table, and even it can be a column in a table. We can also apply this on other objects like transactions, functions, views, etc. So after that we must mention the user. So for that we must type to and then username. It can be a particular user or it can be public. By public we mean all the users. So if we type public, it will be applied on all the users, and even we can specify a role here. About role, we have some slides. I will let you know what does role mean in this topic. And then we have grant option, which allows users to grant access rights to other users. Like if I want a user to be allowed to use this grant command, so I can apply it with the help of this grant option. We have some examples about grant. The first one is to see the list of all assigned privileges to a particular user, or we can say that to show all the grants for a particular user. So now we will check this in our workbench. First of all, we need the list of all the users, and then we will apply that show grant command. So for list of users, I will type select *, from MySQL dot user. With the help of this query, I will get the list of all users in our MySQL server. So here we have the list for all the users, and we have host, then username, and we have attributes for the privileges, like we have select privilege, then insert, update, delete, create. There are so many privileges in this list. Now I want to check the grants for user 1. So here I am going to type show grants for, the name of user is user 1 at, it lies at localhost. So here for user 1 we have grant usage, it can use grant, and it has a role, that is role 1. Now let's have a look for root. So here I am going to type root. Root is actually the administrator of this database. So for root we have grant, select, insert, update, delete. There are almost all the privileges available for root. The next example is to allow user 1 to use select queries. We can say that grant select privilege on student database. The name of database is student dot static, means all the objects lying inside student. These can be all the tables, views, procedures, anything which is inside student database, to the user, which is user 1 and lying in local host. So we are going to check this, but before practicing this query we need to know about the user creation. So there are actually two methods for creating a user in Workbench. First one is through code, and the second one is through the interface. So I will let you know about these two methods. First, check all the users. So I am executing this select query again. Here we have user 1. Before creating a new user, let's delete this user 1. So for this we need drop user, the name of user is user 1 and its host name is localhost. This user has been deleted. Check it again. Now there is no user 1 in the list. Now we need to create a new user. So we have two methods. First one is through interface, the second one is through code. So the first method is to create user through this interface. So here we have administration under navigator. Usually we use this schemas tab for our databases, but for administration we need this tab to be activated. Here in this tab we have users and privileges. With the help of this link we can easily create a new user. So here we have the list of users and I need to create a new user. So for that purpose I will click add account. Here I'm gonna give the name of new user. Here I'm typing test user, and the host name is localhost because we are using our database on our system, so there is no need to type any IP of a remote system. Then type password, again, and here we have apply button, apply. This user has been created. We have test user here in the list. Now we have some other tools in this interface too. We can limit the operations we can reduce or we can limit the number of queries to be executed by test user. Here, zero means that user is allowed to execute any number of queries. We have number of updates, connections, and then concurrent corrections. Then we have administrative roles. We can assign privileges here also, but no need to assign any privilege to test user because we will do this by our code. And we can also assign particular roles or a set of privileges on some schemas to test user. Now we are going back to our code. Here, let me check whether this user is created or not. Look, this test user has been created. Now it is present in the list and it has no privilege. All the privileges are NNN, means no privileges are assigned to this test user. Through code, we can create a user with the help of create user query. So we need to type create user, then name of the user, at name of the host, we are using localhost, then identified by password. So I am giving 12345 as password. With the help of this command, we will create a user named as user1. So create user, name of user is user1, at hostname is localhost, and identified by password 123456. So with the help of this command, we will create a new user at localhost. The name of user would be user1 and its password would be 123456. This user has been created. Let's check the list of users by select query. Here we have user1 and it has no privilege in the list. So we created test user by using the administration tab and then user and privileges link, and then we created user1 with the help of this command. In this tab, we are using root as our user and we can access all these databases and contents inside these databases. For example, if I type here uStudent and then show tables, tables are displayed. Then select static from std, content lying in the table std are also displayed with the help of select query. Now we will log in with our new user, which was user1. So I am going to home and here I will need a new connection. Here I need to type user1 and I'm giving a name as test connection. First we need to test this connection. Password was 123456. Okay, it's working. Click okay. This connection has been created. Now, if you look at into the schemas, none of the databases is present in this list. Previously, we had all the databases present in this tab, but for user1, there is nothing inside schemas tab. So, it means that this new user is not allowed to use any operation on these databases. We need to assign some privileges to user 1. So for that purpose, we will execute some commands. Let's go back to our examples. So the second example is about giving select privilege to user 1 for student database. So for this purpose, we will type this code in our workbench. Now I will move to the root user, and here I will type the command for granting the select privilege to user 1 on student database. So grant select on, name of the database is student dot static. Static means all the objects lying in student, to user 1. This was the name of our user at localhost. This query has been executed. Now if we go back to user 1, we will be able to see the student database. It is present here. All the tables are present in student. Now let's execute the select query. So use student. The student database has been selected. Select static from std. It's working. Now we can use select query on this student database under user 1. Let's check another query. I'm typing insert query. So insert into, table name is std, values, these are reg, sname and address. So for reg, let me check what is the data type of reg. It would be integer. Yes, it is integer. So here I am typing 20, then name and address. Let's check whether this query is working or not under user 1 on student. Control enter, it's not working. We got an error and it says insert command denied to user 1 at localhost for table std. So it means that the user 1 has been given the select privilege only. Insert privilege is not available for user 1. So if we need to grant this insert privilege to user 1, we can use the similar query. Now let's give select and insert privilege to user 1 on student, execute it, and here under user we will try this query again. It's working now. So it means that before it was only select, so insert was not working, but when we executed this grant with select and insert, you can also execute this without select, only insert is enough for insert query. So when we executed this command, after that user 1 got the privilege for insert operation. So after that this query worked. Now if we look into the table, we will have this registration number 20 in the list. Yes, it is present here. If we need to grant all the privileges to user 1 on all the databases, then we need this query: grant all on *** to user 1 at localhost. Now if you look at into our this user 1, it is working with the select and insert. We can grant all the privileges to this user by simply replacing this insert and select with all keyword. Grant all on *** to user 1 at localhost. By executing this command, user 1 would be able to execute all the operations on student database. You can also replace this by **. It would mean that student previously it was student, now user 1 would be able to execute all type of operations on all the databases. But first check the user 1. It has access to student 1. Now I am executing this query. Now go back to user 1, refresh it. It's not working. We will restart this connection and see what happens. Now it has access to all the databases. We can execute any type of query, any type of command on any of these databases. Here we have student database. Inside we have a table std, and inside std we have three columns. Suppose we want to give some privileges on these attributes. Let's say I'm giving select privilege on two of these attributes and insert or update privilege on one of these attributes. For that purpose, we must specify the column names inside the table. Here I am applying select privilege for user 1 on student database, and inside student database we have std table, and inside std table we have two columns, registration and name for select privilege, and for update privilege we have address. So in this way we can specify a particular column inside a table in a database for the grant query. Similarly, we can also use this grant operation for assigning the execute privilege on a particular procedure for a particular user. We are using test connection. Test connection is under user 1. User 1 has access to all these databases, and previously we have granted all the privileges to user 1. So now we are removing all these privileges from user 1. We can say that we are revoking these privileges from user 1. So for that purpose we must type revoke all on *** from user 1 at localhost. Actually it must be from, previously it was to, but here we must use from for the name of user. We are revoking all the privileges on all the databases from user 1. Execute it. It got executed. Now go back to our database, our user 1. It is under test connection. Restart it. Look, under schemas we don't have any database for user 1 under test connection. Our next topic is roles. Actually roles are used for collecting multiple privileges and use these privileges as asset on users. So role is a named collection of privileges. For using roles, we must follow three steps. The first step is to create a new role. Second is to grant privileges to the roles, as we did for our users. We will follow the same procedure. And third step is to grant the roles to the users. So we will go through an example. Here we are creating three roles: role 1, role 2, and role 3. Role 1 would be for development, second would be for read, and third would be for write. The role name is similar to user account that consists of two parts: the role name and the host name. Actually, we will treat these roles as we treated our users. So for role creation, we need to execute such type of commands. So we need to type grant all. We are giving all the privileges. So on object dot static a database, and it's all objects to role 1. So by executing this command, we will give all the privileges to role 1 for a particular database. In second command, we are granting select privilege to role 2 on a particular database and all its object. And in third case, we are granting insert, update, and delete privileges to role 3 on a particular database and all its objects. First check role 1, role 2, and role 3 in our system. So select static from MySQL dot users, as we say that roles are treated as users. So we will find the roles. Here we have role 1 present in the list. So I am going to delete this role, drop role 1. This has been dropped. Now check it again. Role 1 is not present. Now I will create three roles. So create role. Here we have role 1, comma, role 2, comma, role 3. So in this way, we will create three roles. Role 1 is for development, role 2 will use select privileges, and role 3 will be assigned the update, insert, and delete privileges. Three roles are created now. We can check these roles here by using the select query. Role 1, role 2, and role 3 are created. These are present in the list. Now I am granting the privileges to these roles. So for role 1, as I told you that it is for development, so I will grant all the privileges to role 1. So here I am typing grant all on student database and all its objects to role 1. Role 1 has been assigned all the privileges. Now for role 2, grant select on student dot static to role 2. For role 2, we have select privilege. Grant update, insert, delete, select on student dot static. We are giving update, insert, delete, and select privileges on student database with all its object to role 3. Now these three roles have been assigned their privileges. Next is to assign these roles to the users.
Let's check how many users do we have. We have user 1, test user, and root. So I'm creating here 3 users. So create user and user 2 at localhost, identified by password. This user has been created. For user 3, we will have same query. Now 3 users are created. Let's have a look into the list of users. Here we have user 1, user 3, user 2 is not created. Now again check the list. Now we have user 1, user 2, and user 3. We have 3 users in the list of users. Now we will assign these roles, role 1, role 2, and role 3, to these 3 users. For assignment of role, we have same grant query. So type grant, then name of role to the user. So we are assigning role 1 to user 1, and role 2 to user 2, and role 3 to user 3. Grant role 1 to user 1 at localhost. The role 1 has been granted to user 1. Now grant role 2 to user 2 at localhost. Role 2 has been granted to user 2. Grant role 3 to user 3 at local host. So the 3 roles have been granted to the 3 users. Let's check grants for user 1. We have a code for this, show grants for. Here I type user 1 and check the list of grants for user 1. So here we have role 1 for user 1. We can check grants for user 2 in the same way. Role 2 is for user 2. In the same way, I can also check the grants for role 1. So I typed show grants for role 1 at localhost. Actually, role 1 is on all the systems. I think it would be better if I type show grants for role 1. So here we get the list of grants for role 1. We have grant all privileges for role 1. In the same way, we can check the grants for role 3. We have select, insert, update, and delete for role 3 on student database. This was all about data control language DCL, in which we studied grant, revoke, and also the roles. We practiced different queries about these 3 I hope you understand these and will try to practice all these queries. If you have any question, you can put your comments. Thank you.